Welcome back to the Upstate Warm-Up. My name is Scout Hoffmeyer here inside the English Champion Suite inside the Hodge Center. Let's take a look back at last week's competition. The Upstate volleyball team continued their program best stretch in the D1 era, sweeping UNC Asheville at home, giving the team 12 straight sets, winning, entering their matchup against Radford. The men's and women's golf team split the Upstate one day at Carolina Country Club, with the women defeating Gardner-Webb and Wofford, while the men's team dropped their match against Wofford. The Upstate baseball team went 3-1 on the week, picking up a midweek win over PC, following a weekend series against High Point where the Spartans picked up a pair of victories. The men's soccer team continues their best season yet since becoming Division I, as they won on the road against UNC Asheville this past Sunday. Softball continued an unbeaten start to their conference season as they swept PC to go 6-0 in the Big South so far. The Upstate track and field team began outdoor season with a 4-event wins in the 49er Classic. This week I had the opportunity to sit down and catch up with our own Kelly Wiedemann, a member of the women's volleyball team, a member of the men's golf team, Hunter Fry, as well as a member of the men's soccer team, Jerry Montero. Laura Lane has had the opportunity to catch up with men's soccer head coach, Scott Halkett. Now let's take a look at my interview with Jeremy Montero. Welcome back to the Upstate Warm-Up. I am here with Jeremy, a member of the men's soccer team. Jeremy, it is no secret that you are having an impeccable start to your freshman year here as a Spartan. Can you share a little bit about what it's been like to play as a collegiate athlete?
Well, it's been a roller coaster as a freshman. You don't expect really to play that much. Mm-hmm. I've been lucky to play a lot of minutes, but yeah, I'm happy. Happy because I'm playing a lot. Happy to help in the team. Mm-hmm. Happy scoring goals. Happy giving assists. I'm very happy. That's the word.
Good. Happy. Well, we're happy that you're happy. So being from Spain, I can only imagine how difficult it's been to cross over the ocean and be a student at a new university in the middle of a global pandemic. Can you talk a little bit about what it's been like to go through this transition?
I mean, it's been kind of hard, like, because of the family, you mm-hmm. know. I still have some family there, I have some family here. They're helping me a lot here mm-hmm. in the United States. But also having such these great teammates, mm-hmm. it's like a big family, so I feel like I'm in home here in Upstate. So it's okay. Of course, there's struggles, but yeah. I don't really remember that much.
Good. I'm glad to hear that it's like family for you. Upstate men's soccer faces High Point for Saturday night's homecoming matchup. What is it going to take down the Panthers?
It's going to be a tough game, that's for sure. We're both fighting for the top of the conference. Mm-hmm. But we are in our momentum. We know that we can win the conference. Mm-hmm. So we train hard, playing hard, and ready to give everything for this Saturday.
Absolutely. Well, thank you. We are so excited to watch you on Saturday.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Upstate Warm-Up, live from the Ingles Champion Suite inside the Hodge Center. Thanks to Ingles, the official supermarket of the Spartans, and proud to sponsor the K's for Kids program. For every strikeout registered by a Spartan pitcher this season, $1 will be donated to the Hope Remains Ranch here in Spartanburg County. So far this season, the Spartans have registered 309 K's on the season. Special thanks to Ingles, and go Spartans. Next, I had the opportunity to sit down with Kelly Wiedemann, a member of the women's volleyball team. Welcome back to the Upstate Warm-Up. I am here with Kelly, a junior on the women's volleyball team. Kelly, with a few double-doubles under your belt with your first year as a Spartan, how do you feel your training up to this point has allowed you to excel in the ways that you have?
I just feel like it's allowed me to put myself in good positions and being able to help out my team by scoring points or just keeping the ball in play. To put ourselves in good positions to be able to win sets and take games.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, girlfriend. So your journey in collegiate athletics did not start here in Spartanburg. Can you explain where you started, where you came from, and why you landed here at Upstate?
So I went to Missouri State West Plains, which is a two-year junior college, my freshman and sophomore year. And I'm from Missouri, so I played for my mom there, actually. And it just really helped me being able to develop my skills and be able to increase my like court awareness and game knowledge to be able to step up to the next level. And being from a two-year, like Coach Shirley used to coach at a two-year, so it just kind of had a connection. I knew she would understand like how I was trained and all that. And so I just feel like that helped me up my game to be ready for the next level. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So your team has the opportunity, our team has the opportunity to make a big jump in from the preseason polls to the postseason polls with the Radford game and Charleston Southern. So what do you think that our team has to do to be able to get to that next level?
I just think that we really just need to focus on taking care of our own side, not letting things get too chaotic if things on the other side are chaotic. And just playing to how we know how to play. Sometimes we tend to get a little sloppy at times, but just staying composed and keeping our side controlled and controlling what we can will really just help amp us up into the next four games.
Absolutely. Well, I'll see you on the court tonight.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Kelly.
This weekend, we celebrate the 40th year of our men's soccer program and caught up with former Rifle Boy, a current Upstate head soccer coach, Scott Halkett.
Hello, this is Laura Elanis, and today we have the head coach from the soccer team. Thank you, Coach, for having us today.
It's great to be here.
Coach, you are off to a great start in Big South play. 5 wins and a tie in your first 6 matches. What has been the key to your success this year as a team?
I think the key to our success is the players. We have spent a lot of time on the road, traveling throughout the world and throughout America, recruiting the right kids that came in. And with our help, they've created the right culture to grow and be successful. So when we look at the success this year, it's been coming for a couple of years. We had a 2019, we had a very, very young team, and they did really, really well. They played very well, but we didn't get the results. And since then, we've seen them grow. They've matured. They've become better players. And the success they've having is because of the hard work they've played in, and they've got the right character. They've bought into growing individually and growing as a team. And we've seen the results this year.
Okay. And Coach, individually, who have been some of the players who have stood out and taken a leadership role for you this season?
I think the first two players I have to talk about is Paul Manals and Justin Hines. They are captains, and they've done an excellent job in breeding the right culture. They've led through example, both on and off the field. And they've helped create this culture where this growth mindset within the team. So they've done really well. But I think it's such a young team, and there's so many other players. I could list another 7, 8, 9 players that have really, you can see they've matured personally as people, but they've also matured on the field. So not only do we have our two captains that have become leaders and are leading the team in the right way, but the support group they've got through all these other guys that are leaders in their own way, that are helping this team accomplish what they've accomplished so far.
Okay. Coach, your opponent Saturday, High Point, is also fighting for the top of the Big South. What can we expect on Saturday night in the matchup?
I think it's going to be a great game. I think it's going to be a really good game. They're a good team. They're getting great results. They're scoring goals. And they're a tough team to break down. So it's going to be a really, really good game between two really good teams. The one thing I can say, they ranked nationally right now. They near the top of the, I think, the top 30 in the country. So we're still the underdog. We haven't won anything. They've won the conference before. They've done things that we haven't done. So this year, they undefeated. They beat Campbell, and we tied with Campbell. So we're still coming into this game as underdogs. So we've still got something to prove. I think the game is going to be fantastic. It's going to be a great example of college soccer.
Thank you. Coach, final question. As an alum of this program, how gratifying is it for you to have so many alumni coming back for homecoming and re-engaging with the program this season?
I think it is fantastic to see all these old guys coming back and being part of the program and coming to the campus. The guys that are coming back, and a lot of the guys that can't make it that are the alumni, they established the legacy of this program. When it was NAIA, it was Division II when it first got started in the 80s and 90s. These are the guys that helped establish the legacy here. And then the guys that played in the 2000s, you know, it takes a long time to build a successful program, and they're part of it. You know, it was really well done at NAIA in Division II, and now we're trying to do it Division I. So it's great to see them get re-engaged. It's great to see them begin to pay more attention to the program and to support the program, just physically being here to support the players on the field, but also financially, you know, because we need the financial support. So it's a thrill for me to see some of these guys I haven't seen for years come back to campus and to be able to meet with them and meet their families and re-engage with them. So it's fantastic to see.
Thank you, Coach. I wish you the best, and I hope you all win the conference.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And this was Offset Warm-Up with Laura Ilanis. Thank you.
Men's golfer Hunter Fry had an outstanding start to his senior season, having won the UNCW Seahawk Invitational. I had the opportunity to sit down with Mr. Fry and hear about his goals for the rest of the season.
Welcome back to the Upstate Woman. My name is Scout, and I am here with Hunter Fry, a graduate student on our men's golf team. Hunter, you have finally reached your goal, an individual win at the UNCW Invitational, along with a Big South Golfer of the Week honor. How does this achievement feel?
It feels pretty good. It's just, it shows that my hard work is starting to pay off. It's been a long road since freshman year. I've come a long way, and I'm glad it's finally starting to pay off, and looking forward to the rest of the season.
Absolutely. So with little time left as a Spartan, what is one more thing you hope to accomplish with your time here at Upstate?
I would really like to make regionals as an individual. Right now I'm in position to do that, and our next tournament is a great opportunity to kind of help boost that opportunity. And I would also like to win conference.
Absolutely. That's everyone's goal. That's everyone's goal. So you're a little different. You're actually a grad student here. What are your next steps after you get your master's degree?
So after I graduate with my master's, I plan to turn professional and try to play for a couple of years, and hopefully that works out. If not, I'm falling back on my master's degree.
There you go. Well, we are so lucky to have you here at Upstate, and good luck the rest of your time.
Thank you.
Now it's time for the stat of the day, brought to you by the South Carolina Education Lottery. Our women's softball team leads the Big South Conference in 13 statistical categories and ranks in the top 50 nationally in 10 categories. Now it's time to take a look ahead for Spartan Athletics. Track and field continues their outdoor season at Winthrop Invite this weekend. Volleyball hosts Radford Thursday at 6 p.m. and Friday at 4 p.m. on ESPN+, and then travels to Charleston Southern for a pair of games on Monday at 6 p.m. and Tuesday at 2 p.m. also on ESPN+. Baseball travels to Winthrop Friday at 5 p.m., which will be on ESPN+, and a Saturday doubleheader starting at 1 p.m. Softball returns to action on Wednesday as they have a road doubleheader against Western Carolina. Men's soccer hosts High Point for Senior Day and Homecoming this Saturday at 5 p.m. on ESPN+. Men's golf competes in Jacksonville this weekend, and women's soccer returns home to take on UNC Asheville this Saturday in the first game of the soccer doubleheader at 2 p.m., and then has a rescheduled matchup against Presbyterian College at 7 p.m. on Wednesday on ESPN+. This has been Scout Hoffmeyer saying so long from the English Champion Suite, and I will see you all next week.